Hello everyone, in this video we'll design a fluorescent lamp that you can see on the desktop right now. And for making that, first we'll design this lower part, and after that we'll design this upper portion. So let's start with the reveal feature. For that, first go to the sketch and select the front plane. Now we will insert a center line. After that, we will draw a sketch that will be revolved in order to make the lower part. For that, go to the line, then draw a horizontal line, then a vertical line, again a horizontal line, then vertical line, then an inclined line, then vertical line, and then horizontal, again vertical, and a horizontal line. After making this rough sketch, we'll give it the exact dimensions. For that, go to the smart dimensions, and then we'll give all the dimensions one by one. So here it is 19, it is 5, it is 1, it is 15, it is 5 in vertical, it is 8, and this last one is 12. Now here we have to give the angle. So this angle is 120. And here this horizontal line is of 2. So here we have given all the dimensions. After that, we have to give the fillet. For that, select the fillet. And here we'll enter the fillet parameter as a radius 4 mm, and then select this and this, and after that select this and this, and then click on OK. And fillet of 2 mm that we will give over here, then OK. So now we have to complete the sketch, and for that we will draw a vertical line. So we will draw a vertical line like this, and we will trim this portion. And then we will exit the sketch. Now go to the features and select the revolve boss feature and click on OK. So after making this, we have to first complete this lower portion. And to complete this, first here we have to make a sketch. So go to the sketch, select this, and here we will make a sketch. For that, select the ellipse and we will draw an ellipse like this. Now we'll draw a vertical line that divides the ellipse into two parts, and we'll trim out this half portion. Okay, and we'll give dimensions. So here it is of 5 mm, and then we'll exit the sketch. Now go to the features and select the revolve boss feature. Here we have to select the axis of rotation. So select this vertical line, and here we have to given the angle. So angle should be 180, and here we will reverse the angle, then click on OK. We have to make the mirror of this. For that, select this revolve, then click on the mirror, and here we will select the front plane, then click on OK. Now we have to also give fillet over here, so select the fillet, then select this edge, and here fillet radius will be 0.5 mm. Then here also there is a fillet, and here also there is a fillet. Then click on OK. Now we have to also make electrodes over these two sides. For that we have to make a plane. So here go to the reference geometry, select the plane. Now here select the front plane, and here we have to give the distance. So the distance will be 13 mm, or let it be 15 mm. Then click on OK. Go to the sketch. Now here we have to draw one circle. So here we draw a circle like this, and here the diameter of that circle will be of 4 mm. Then we'll give the distance. So here this distance will be of 5 mm. Then exit the sketch, go to the features, select the extruded boss feature, and here we'll reverse the direction, and in this drop down select up to the next, then click on OK. We'll also give it mirror. So here click on the mirror, and here select the front plane, then click on OK. Now after making this, we will make a cut portion over here. So go to the sketch, select this upper face. Now here first we will draw a circle, and then we will give it the dimension. So here it has diameter of 7 mm, and distance from the origin will be 16.5 mm. Now we'll draw a line like this. And then we'll trim this portion. Now we'll exit the sketch, go to the features, select the extruded curve feature, and here give it as a 1 mm, then OK. We have to mirror this, so select the cut extrude, then select the mirror, and here we have to select the front plane, and then OK. Now we will hide this plane. So here our lower portion is completed. Now we'll move to the upper portion. Now to make upper portion, first we'll make two planes. For that go to the reference geometry plane and select the surface, and the first plane is at a distance of 5, and then OK. We have to place another plane which is at a distance of 50 from this plane, and then OK. After that, first we have to make two helix, and for that first we have to draw two circles. So here go to the sketch, select this plane, and we'll draw two circles. So here first we'll draw first circle, and diameter is 33. Then OK. After drawing a circle, go to the features, and in curves select the helix and spiral. Now here we have to select the height and revolution. height will be 50 mm and revolution will be 2, and make sure that start angle is 180 degree, and then click on OK. After that we have to make another helix. For that go to the sketch and select that plane. Now we will draw another circle of same diameter. And then exit the sketch. Now go to the features, then curves, select helix and spiral. Now here start angle should be 0 degree and remaining will be same, it means height is 50 mm and revolution is 2. Then click on OK. After drawing these two, we have to place another two planes. For that, select the reference geometry plane. Now here, select the front plane and the distance is 16.5. And then OK. And now we'll place another plane, and that is at a distance of 33 and in reverse direction. So here we will click on the flip offset, then OK. After making these two planes, we have to draw a sketch on those two planes, or we can simply draw that sketch on the single plane, but let's sketch on these two planes separately. So here go to the sketch, select the plane, and here we have to draw two vertical lines. For that select the line, and here we'll select the line from this point like this. Now here we have to give the pyres feature. For that you have to select this end point, then press Ctrl and select this curve and select here pyres, and then click on OK, and we'll exit the sketch. The same thing we have to do on another side. For that go to the sketch, select this plane, same way select the line, select this lower point and draw a line like this. I'm sorry, I have drawn on the same plane. So here I will close the sketch. Now go to the sketch and select this plane, now we'll draw same vertical line, then we'll select this end point, select the curve and click on the pyres, then OK. Now after drawing this, we have to draw on this horizontal plane. So here exit the sketch, now go to the sketch, select this horizontal plane. Now we will draw a sketch by using the spline feature. For that here select the spline, we will draw a spline like this. After drawing the spline, we have to do the same thing, it means we have to select this end point of the spline, select this curve and select here pyres, then OK. And the same thing we have to do on this side. So select the end point, select the curve and select here pyres, then okay, and then exit the sketch. Now in order to use the sweep feature, we have a continuous curve, and for that we have to make the combined curve. And for that, go to the features and in curve select here composite curve. After selecting the composite curve, we have to select all the separate portions. For that, select this part, select this helix, then select this upper spline and select this helix and select this line, and then click on OK. So here we have make a composite curve. After making a composite curve, we have to draw a section for which we want to make the sweep feature. For that, go to the sketch, select this surface. Now here we have to draw a circle that is concentric with this circle. So here we will draw circle like this and having the diameter of 5.5 mm, then exit the sketch. After drawing a circle, go to the features and select the sweep boss feature. Now here we have to give the path. For that, we have to select that comp curve, and here you can see that it has taken the comp curve and it has made this upper portion. Now before that, here select the none and we have to make the thin features. For that, select on the thin feature, and here the thickness is 0.5, and then click on OK. So after making this, we will hide all these unwanted portions. So here we will hide this plane also, this plane, and this curve also. Now we will do some rendering, and for that, first we will give here backdrop. After that, here we'll select this shaded, and now let us select this revolve, and here this boss extrude, this mirror. Then we'll go to here plastic, and in plastic we'll select the soft touch, and in soft touch select this white. And after that, here we have to give this light. For that, select the sweep, then here go to the appearance, and in appearance go to the lights. In light, go to the neon tube, and here we have to select this white color. So here in this tutorial we have completely made this fluorescent tube. Before that, here we have to give this another color. For that, select the extrude boss mirror, go to the here metal, in metal go to the bronze, and we'll give like this. So in this tutorial we have made a complete fluorescent bulb using the SolidWorks. Thanks for watching my video. For more videos and updates, subscribe my channel SolidWorks Tutorials. Thanks.